What is going on, everyone? Welcome back to the world according to Briggs. Today we're going to make a video that has been requested a bunch lately. Where is the cheapest city to buy a home? We've looked at a lot of different places and a lot of different ways to get a home in the last few months, but never the cheapest city. Some people don't care about crime or poverty or employment stats. They just want to know where the cheapest city that they can actually own the roof that's over their head. I always say if something's too cheap, there's a reason. On this list, we won't be discussing those reasons. We are just going to look at the price. Let's just assume all these cities have horrible crime and poverty and everything else like that. We're just going to look at the price. What is your mortgage going to look like? This video will be shorter than average for this channel, so leave me a comment and tell me if you like the longer or the shorter videos, and maybe we'll adjust going forward. All right, so with all that being said, why don't we take a look at the cities you could buy a home making somewhere around minimum wage? The first city is one we haven't talked about before. It's number 10, Gary, Indiana. Gary, Indiana is just south of Chicago, and it's considered the jewel on Lake Michigan. I'm totally kidding. No one has ever said that about Gary, Indiana. This place has been in all-around bad shape since the 1940s, and people finally realized this around the 1960s. That's the last decade they didn't have a shrinking population. Here's the thing about Gary. It has a laundry list of problems, but the homes in a lot of the areas really aren't that bad. They could stand a little more effort in the upkeep department, but for a depressed city, it isn't crazy ugly like in many neighborhoods and other big cities. The median home value here is $83,000. About 65% of the homes in Gary, Indiana are less than $100,000. The average household income here is about $36,000 a year. You could afford a $100,000 home making that kind of money. Number 9, South Bend, Indiana. That's right, Indiana's a twofer on this list. South Bend, Indiana is on the St. Joseph River near the southernmost bend. That's how it's got its name, South Bend. Get it? Anyway, it is also home to the University of Notre Dame's Fighting Irish. This is another city losing people. Maybe they're just hiding. I don't know. But what that does mean is prices for homes will continue to drop and they will have more empty homes for you to choose from. Unlike Gary, Indiana, they did have one census since 1960 where they actually gained population. That was the 2000 census and they gained 2%. This next one coming up this year, 2020, they expect to lose close to 10% of the population. That's a big drop. Like I said, just means more land to choose from. South Bend, like so many other cities in this part of the country, had to demolish homes that had been vacant for far too long. Just too many bad things happen when you have vacant homes everywhere. They did a decent job. That means there's open lands for you to build on. Just gotta choose one. The median home value here in South Bend is $81,000. The share of homes worth less than $100,000 is 65%. Number 8, Akron, Ohio. Akron is the fifth largest city in the state of Ohio. Akron was founded in 1825 along the Cuyahoga River at the start of the Ohio and Erie Canal. If you don't know anything about the Ohio Erie Canal, you should give it a Google. It's very interesting. For its time, it was quite the engineering marvel. From 1862 to 1913, the canal served as pretty much a water source and a major form of transportation for all the towns and industries along its route. But during 1913, much of the canal system was abandoned after it got flooded. Apparently, they had really bad floods. By this time, trains had taken over, so there was really no need to repair it. They just kind of left it. But, cool piece of trivia, U.S. President James Garfield worked the canal driving mules as a teenager. That's kind of interesting. If you want to live near the canal, the median home value in Akron is only $80,100. The share of homes worth less than $100,000, it's just under 68%. 68% of the homes here you can get for under $100,000. That's crazy. And the median household income isn't terrible. It's $36,000 a year. I mean, terrible for a depressed town. There's much worse in this country. Number 7, Rochester, New York. Ah yes, Rochester, New York. Upstate New York. I have a lot of family that live there, and I'm sure I'm going to get a few Facebook messages after this video posts. That's because I'm here to tell you that this once great city has now slipped into the sucks category. Using the broken down cars on the lawn rating system, with 5 being the worst, Rochester gets a 4. The median home value in Rochester is $79,400. Yeah. That's cheap. The percentage of the homes that are under $100,000 are 67. 67% of the home here are under $100,000. The median household income is about $33,000 a year in Rochester. Number 6, Youngstown, Ohio. Youngstown, Ohio is about 15 minutes away from the Pennsylvania border. If you ever visit New Bedford, Pennsylvania, and you see a sign or hear someone say, build that wall, they aren't talking about Mexico, they're talking about Youngstown. The median home value is $78,900. The share of the homes in Youngstown under $100,000 are 68%. 68% of the homes are under $100,000. Number 5, Toledo, Ohio. And yet another Ohio city that you can buy a home on a paper route salary. Before you leave a comment, I don't hate Ohio. I've visited many times, I have many friends there, and I'm a lifelong Cleveland Browns fan. I'm going off stats. Stats that show the Rust Belt of this nation is in bad shape. And if you don't know what the Rust Belt is, it's an area up there near Toledo, Cleveland, Gary, Indiana, Detroit, that used to be big in manufacturing, cars, whatever. And since the 80s, it's had a serious decline. And it's showing on stats like this. Anyway, stop typing. The median home value in Toledo is $77,600. The share of the homes that are under $100,000 is 67.5%. The median household income in Toledo is $36,000 a year. Number 4, Lansing, Michigan. Right between Detroit and Grand Rapids, Michigan, you have another Rust Belt cautionary tale called Lansing. Lansing is just like Flint, Michigan, with better drinking water. And in the 1960s, they had an elephant incident. On September 26, 1963, a 12-year-old, 3,000-pound female dancing elephant rebelled against her trainer during a performance at a shopping center circus near what was then Logan Street and Holmes Road in Lansing. She ran out of the tent and into the streets and was chased by around 4,000 local residents. How did this happen? How did 4,000 people find out there's an elephant roaming the street and decide to give chase? What was going on in their heads? What was going on in the elephant's head? The incident ended with the shooting of the elephant by the Lansing Police Department, sadly. But I think, you know, when 4,000 people are chasing you, you weigh 3,000 pounds, there's never going to be a good outcome here. They couldn't reason with the elephant at that point. Anyway, the median home value in Lansing is $77,000. I have no information on insurance against elephants attacks, so don't ask. The share of the homes worth less than $100,000 is 72%. The median household income in Lansing is $39,000 a year. Number 3, Cleveland, Ohio. And back to Ohio. The city is located on the southern shore of Lake Erie, across the U.S. maritime border with Canada, and it is like ground zero for the Rust Belt right behind Detroit. Cleveland is a city losing people like they just announced they are giving mandatory prostate exams on a daily basis. If you have no idea what that means, wait until you're 40. You'll laugh then. Like I said before, when a city is losing people, prices go down and availability goes up for homes. The median home value in Cleveland currently is $67,000. Let that sink in. $67,000. Man. Anyway, the percentage of homes under $100,000 is 76% of the homes. Over three quarters of the homes are under $100,000. But the average median household income here is about $27,000, so, you know, they're barely making payments. Number 2, Dayton, Ohio. If you buy a home in Dayton, Ohio, make sure you have a ton of insurance. There's a potential for everything to happen in this city. The same goes for your car. Nobody wants to make a mortgage payment or a car payment on something that isn't there anymore. They get tornadoes, floods, fires, and idiots stealing cars here all the time. Well, maybe not the disasters all the time, but they get enough of them. People stopped moving here around the 1960s, and by the mid-1970s, they were in full retreat. They are expected to lose another 2% of their population this year. The median home value in Dayton, Ohio is $66,000. That's it. Almost 80% of the homes are under $100,000. But the median household income is $30,000. It's not as bad as other places, but it's still pretty bad. And number 1, Detroit, Michigan. Yeah, Detroit. Imagine that. Hey, at least Ohio didn't make the top spot, right? Detroit is the poster child for the death of American manufacturing. You've heard of company towns, where almost everyone in the town works for a single company. When the company fails, so does the town. Detroit was an industry town. Most residents work in the auto manufacturing industry or in some sort of supporting industry. Now, there's still auto industry jobs in Detroit, but nothing near what they had in the 1950s, 60s, and 70s. I'm talking like 10% of what they had. The good news is, they're starting to show signs of recovery. They have a long way to go, but business service companies have relocated, medical coding companies, and I read about big cleanup and restoration companies are looking at Detroit now. That's a good sign. Currently, they're still a pretty sad city, but that's all good news for someone looking to buy a cheap home that doesn't have wheels or a tent roof, you know? The median home value in Detroit right now, the average, is $42,800. Under 50 grand, you can own a home in Detroit. And in some cases, they'll let you just pay the back taxes. The percentage of homes worth under $100,000 is 85%. 85% of the homes are under $100,000. But sadly, the median household income here is about $28,000 a year. All right, everyone, those are the cheapest cities you could buy a home in right now. Like I said, forget all the crime and all that other stuff. If you're just looking for a cheap house and you want to get in someplace, this is where you go. Might be dangerous, might be, you know, bad neighborhood, and the house might need a lot of work, but you can get a home. Some people, that stuff doesn't matter. They just want a home. And here you go. Anyway, don't forget all the links below. Give this video a big thumbs up. Tell me what you thought. Don't forget to subscribe. Everybody have a great day. Be nice to each other.